Rolls the puck ahead. Biot on his off wing. Twists back around. Tries to work the puck low. He gets it around behind. Union tries to stuff the puck out in front a couple of times. It's cleared aside. Scribbins gets back to his feet. Matheson, there's a turnaround attempt. That's cleared aside. Another chance right out in front. That one went just wide. Another chance in front, save. Rebound chance is cleared aside. And the referee says no.
And that came off. That's what he's saying. And I don't even know if the puck went in anyway. You know, that just about 5 seconds before that, that was off of Scriven's shoulder as he was going down. The best minute and a half for Union in this game, but it appears it might be too little too late. But let's see if the referee wants to at least look at this replay. And we're going to look at it first. But Union finally pounding guys to the net. You see the net coming off. I'm not, oh, there's the puck. I don't even think it ever went in.
Here's another good chance to look at it from our overhead angle.
That goes wide of the net initially. Union able to get it out in front of the seat.
Right there in the
pounding
crease.
I was kicked at. Now the puck. Trying to.
There it is. It never went in.
No.
And there's the whistle.
At least it doesn't appear that it ever went in it from that perspective. Now, how would it have gotten back to where, you know, you lose it, you lose sight of it for a second there.
I believe it's right under the Cornell defender standing there.
I don't know what there. I do see a little black by Scriven's glove, but I'm not sure if that's the puck. But the, you see the net did come off.
Let's bring in Bob on this one.
Remember, the only replay the referee has is the overhead angle. He has none of the other replays that we have on TV. So Peter Fiola looking at it right now, the only replay he's got is the overhead angle. I got to agree with you. I don't think it went in the net. Even if it did, I think the net was off before, but I think it was under Scrivener or another player the whole time. And he had, was vociferously saying the puck and the net came off for the puck if it crossed line. If it did, I don't think it did.
This could take a while, though, to review, Bob, because you do lose sight of the puck there for a second. Right there, I can't see where it went. Now, you see Scribbins, there's a...
He kicks something in.
Yeah, you see him kick it back out. So it does... It does cross... If that's the puck, it does cross the line, and the net is just coming off right at the same time.
Let's look to see if it might be the black tape on a stick,
it's
though.
It's Scriven's kicking the net off with his right pad as he's pushed into the net. And that is, I got to tell you, that's a very difficult decision, but...
Union players think it went in. The Union players are convinced it went in.
Now, if the guys were standing right there and they saw it go in, I'll trust them more than I can trust what I can see on that replay. Now, so the question then becomes whether the net was off by then. And
well, our referee crew has a...
That's a toughie.
Peter Fiola and Tim Kutera.
One thing to remember, too, boys. Another thing to remember on this, guys, is that if a Union player pushed the Cornell player into the net, that's why a goal wouldn't count.
There it is. The puck is in.
Yeah, okay. So that is the puck.
Good work by the crew.
But the net was coming off already, A, and it...
And the Union player pushed him into the net.
And he also kicked it in, Bob. I think he may have also done that. But like you said, all they saw was the overhead shot.
Still, it's a great no call here by the Peter Fiola and the crew.
Here's a shot. That one's blocked. Another chance. That's just wide. 32 seconds remain. Puck chipped.
Hey, Scotty Garrow, the heck of a catch right to my left.
And 29.6 seconds remain in the third period.
Well, Cornell is just 29.6 seconds away from their 12th ECAC championship, a number 2 seed in the NCAA tournament. They've represented this league in the NCAAs better than anyone in the last 15 years.
If the refs only had the above camera, above net camera, that's the only one they could have called it on.
That was a great stop by Scribbins.
Oh, it's all the way down. Is going to move on to the NCAA tournament and capture their 12th ECAC Ice Hockey Men's Championship here at the Times Union Center in Albany, New York. You don't often get a goal from that far away, clearing it on a defensive play.
Yeah, look at that. I mean, that's what I reacted to. That was Patrick Kennedy, I believe, firing it all the way from there. Not sure he would have attempted to do that if it was only 1-0, but 2-0, what the heck?
Well, it's all over except for the last 15 seconds.
Well, I don't mean this to sound condescending, Greg, but Union played a fantastic last 2 minutes. It's just unfortunate that was all for them.
Puck along the wall to the far side, and time runs out. The Big Red of Cornell have won the 2010 ECAC Ice Hockey Championships here in Albany, New York at the Times Union Center. You see the players congratulating one another. Soon they'll be skating around with the Whitelaw Cup. The coaches shaking hands at center ice.
Well, this group of seniors has never won it. And for Cornell, that's unusual.
There you see Mike Schaefer, Nate Lehman and his staff at Union, and the players and the fans for Cornell just enjoying this moment.
And Cornell's shutout streak, 3 straight games now, Greg, by identical 3-0 scores.
Well, Scribbins is Mr. Zero.
Well, as much as we said tonight that Union just did not have their night, let's give credit to that program. They've come a long way. Nate Lehman's done a fantastic job, and I do want to give my kudos to them. Sometimes you have to lose one before you come back and get one the next time.
Well, there you see Scribbins, and now the very great tradition of handshaking happening at center ice. Cornell wins 3-0. We'll back to wrap it up in just a moment.